spend my life mending broken people. I want to spend my life removing pain. Lord, let my words heal a heart that hurts. I want to spend my life mending broken people. I want to spend my life mending broken people.
Hello and welcome to another 3ABN Today program. I'm Jason Bradley and I'm excited about what we're going to be talking about. We're going to give you an update on what's going on at 3ABN Trinidad and Tobago. And I want to introduce you to someone who has been a volunteer with 3ABN Trinidad and Tobago, and his name's Rodney Reynold. Welcome to the program, Rodney.
Thank you very much, Jason.
It's great to have you here. I see you at all these events. I see you at ASI. I see you at GC. I see you just at so many different events. But this is your first time at 3ABN's headquarters, correct?
Yes, it is.
Wow.
It is.
Wow. Yeah. I'm glad you could make it out here. How long have you been a volunteer with?
I've been a volunteer for 3ABN in Trinidad and Tobago for 14 years.
14 years?
Yes, 14 years.
Wow, 14 years.
Yeah.
And you are gifted in the area of marketing
and
establishing connections and networking and all of that stuff. I've noticed that.
Yes,
I've definitely noticed that.
Yes.
We're going to dive into your background and all that stuff because we want to find out who you are. We want our viewing audience to find out who you are, who's the volunteer that's in Trinidad and Tobago. But before we do, we're gonna go ahead and go to a song. We're gonna be blessed in song by Pam Lister, and the song is entitled Written in Red.
I love you.
what a beautiful song. We're here talking to Brother Rodney Reynold. And Rodney, you have been volunteering for 14 years, as you said before we went into the song.
Yes.
You know, I really love the scripture that's found in 1 Corinthians chapter 12, really just that whole chapter where it's talking about spiritual gifts, unity and diversity, and then also unity and diversity in one body. It's interesting because it's kind of like talking about the coexistence of the different parts of the body, but they all make up, you know, the body, and all the different parts are needed for different functions. And in ministry, we need members to be mobilized, to be doing things around the world, because the gospel is to go into the entire world. And you're out there, 3ABN, Trinidad and Tobago, volunteering your time, and you've done quite a few things, and, you know, by the grace of God. And to prove it, I've got a long list of notes here of different events and all kinds of stuff that we're going to talk about, and I'm excited about that. But let's get into your background. Who is Rodney? How did you grow up? And were you always in the church?
Yeah, I grew up in the east of Trinidad, in Manzalina. That's on the eastern side. And lived there for a short time, then moved on to the city, Port of Spain, and lived there for most of my life.
Okay, and what city was that?
Port of Spain.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
So on a little island of at least 1.5 million, that's the capital, and it's much more populated as well.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Wow, little island, 1.5 million people.
Yes, yeah.
That sounds like a nice size island.
Yes, it is, it is, it is,
yes. It is. Okay, yeah. And were you always in the church?
Most of my life I was in the church. I was brought up in the church. My parents brought us up in the church. Before they got married, they were Hindus. And they went to a crusade, and someone invited them, and they found out more about the Bible and more about love, and they accepted the message of salvation, Jesus.
Wow.
And they became members of the Adventist Church. Mm-hmm. And there they brought us up, Christian life, vegetarian as well, and a whole beautiful lifestyle.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so that was a complete shift for them, because Hindus, don't they have a polytheist, like in terms of, like, don't they worship multiple
gods? Yes, they do.
They went from that to accepting Christ as their personal Lord and Savior.
Yes, God really called them just before they got married, actually, and he called them, and they accepted the Lord. And they, from that time when they got baptized, they just were on fire for the Lord. They did a lot of missionary work for community events. Almost every month, they cook about 500 meals for the homeless. And from the East Coast, we would drive down on a Sunday and give out the food and drinks. And this would be at our expense as well.
Wow, so you've been doing all kinds of ministry-oriented volunteer work for a long, long time, longer than 14 years.
Yes, 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 yeah. I have my parents to thank for how they have brought us up. Mm-hmm. They have showed us the love of God by helping others and by their lifestyle and a whole lot of things. And who I am today is because of how they brought us up when we were small.
So when did you fall in love with Christ?
That journey in my life, before I go there, my parents wanted us as their children to grow up in the church. The do's and the don'ts used to get to me a lot.
Okay.
A lot. Mm-hmm. So on most Sabbath afternoons, as soon as Sabbath is over, I would run around the church fast over and over because Sabbath was over.
So, church was over?
When Sabbath was over.
So that night? Okay.
Yeah. Uh-huh. So that's in the afternoon, and Sabbath afternoon. And then my parents used to get upset because of that, because I'm so happy that the Sabbath is over. Back then, it was a burden for me as a child. And parents are teaching the do's and the don'ts of God's word. And at that time in my life, I wasn't in love with God. Mm-hmm. When I was 17, around there, God showed me, I got a little book called Alone with God. And God impressed me to continue reading that book. Mm-hmm. And he showed me how much he loved me. And then that's how I got to fall in love with God and get to do what he wants us to do, what he wants me to do as well. And that's how I get to know the love and the joy of being in God's presence and doing what his will in my life.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Now, I remember talking to you prior to this program, and you were telling me about that book that
yes.
you read.
Yes.
And you shared a story in that book, and you gave some examples.
Yes.
Or an example. And I thought it was a really good example. Why don't you share what you shared with me?
Being in love with God, it's a marriage, like a marriage.
Mm-hmm.
Husband and wife married together, and the man make a list for his wife almost every day, to-do lists, and she keeps doing this over and over, week by week, and it became a burden for her. Just doing the lists, the things on the list.
So the man in the book made a list for his wife.
Yes.
And
yes.
The list that he made for his wife was a burden to her.
Yes.
Because it was something she was supposed to do over and over.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. And so she kept on doing this, and it became such a burden for her and a challenge to do so often. And apart from that factor, other factors, they got separated. Mm-hmm. So when she got married, years down the road, she went up into the attic and she came across the list of things that her first husband gave her. And she got very angry and said, look at how her husband used to treat her and give her this to-do list and such. And then she keep reading the list one by one, and she realized, but I do this, I do this, and I do all of this. And then she gets to realize that because she loves her husband, and it's because of love she gets to do these things. That's how, when you're in love with God, how you enjoy being in his presence, you enjoy doing his will and working for him.
Yes, yes. So she was motivated by love.
Yes.
And so that list that seemed like it was burdensome, wasn't even burdensome at all, and she was doing it out of love.
Yes, and I'm sure she could have done more because mm-hmm. she's in love with him.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. And that's, you know, for a lot of us, that's like the Ten Commandments.
Absolutely.
You know, and the Word of God, there's so many people that view it as a burden, things that they can't do. They think that it's restrictive, but really, it's all about love. Like, God is love, and when we love him,
yes.
we want to keep those. We don't want to hurt God. We
Correct.
Want to please God.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Yes. So tell me more about your background.
Well, I served in the Person Ministries Department in the City Church
mm-hmm.
for over 10 years.
Okay.
And during that timeline, we encounter a lot of challenges in reaching people.
Mm-hmm.
And sometime after that, Danny Shelton came down to Trinidad
mm-hmm.
and at the convention, and that's where I heard him speak.
Mm-hmm.
And I caught the vision. I met him there and I spoke with him. I tried then for him to speak with the current cable company in the island. We would analog then, not digital.
Okay.
So that was just one cable provider. And now we have over 7 cables.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of the challenges that we've had in the island is where people were not interested in hearing about God's word, not interested in hearing what you have to say when you go to speak with them. And then when I heard Danny's book, and I got his message, and I caught that vision, what he wants to do, it all in line with what challenges that we face there. And it was really amazing to know that treatment is already in your house. Mm-hmm. It's already in your home. Mm-hmm. All we have to do is find a way to direct you to the channel, mm-hmm. which is simply by putting a flyer in your mailbox and letting you know that here's what you can watch for EBN Lifestyle Television Station.
So by putting a flyer in the mailbox,
yes.
You were letting them know.
You let them know, yeah. You wouldn't have to interact with them, those who don't want to interact with you, but those who are willing to have a conversation, mm-hmm. you let them know the benefits of watching for EBN 24/7 first-class lifestyle programs.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. And when for EBN came on board, I resigned all my posts, kept one post, Mm-hmm. 3ABN, and it's been so for 14 years. And it has been a sweet, beautiful journey and a great joy in making things happen in my island. And it only happens by God.
Amen.
Only by Him. He guides me, direct me, connect me mm-hmm. in ways that only when I check back, that was God.
Yes.
That was God, you know.
Yes.
And it is just so amazing how we put things together. I just had to say, thank you, Lord.
Yes.
We need more.
Uh-huh.
Yes. So He has done tremendous things in our island, and some of the projects that we discuss, mm-hmm. List here, that's just some of what we do. There are many other things that we do to try to reach people with 3ABN and let them know what we can do to help their life as well.
Mm-hmm. So let's talk about some of those projects, because in 14 years of doing this, I know that you have some powerful testimonies and stories and different events that you've been a part of. Let's talk about some of those.
Yes. The projects that we do helps build our relationship with the people in the community mm-hmm. at ground level, at one-on-one, and it builds network, it builds bridges, it builds relationship, and it gets people to understand that this is what TDY190052 is, the island, and this is what we offer. And they're so amazed to know that the quality that programs that TDY190052 offer, they just say, wow. Some of them has come to me and said, I did not know you exist.
Mm-hmm.
And I get that sometimes a lot, I used to, mm-hmm. but now in my island, there's a larger portion of people know, because we try our best to be present in community events
uh-huh.
so that people could know what we are. If it's, we had a community event for the entire day and at least one person get to know of 3ABN,
mm-hmm.
that's enough for me.
Mm-hmm.
That's enough for me. Because I know that one person, once they get to fall in love with God by watching 3ABN, it will grow from there and they will pass it on.
Yes.
And that's enough, because that is cast in stone.
Uh-huh, yeah. Uh-huh.
So one of the projects that we did was a huge project with Spiritual Vigilantes Books.
Mm-hmm.
In 2017, we requested 50,000 Spiritual Vigilantes Books.
50,000 Spiritual, oh wow, look at all those boxes that are
yeah.
behind you guys.
Yeah. That's most of the boxes there. That's 50,000 boxes there. The volunteers came together. That's some of the volunteers, actually. And from downstairs to upstairs, we carried it. And then in the community, we mobilized. We put the books into plastic bags mm-hmm. and put our flyers there and stamp it. And we went into the places in our island that is not reached.
Mm-hmm.
And we cover that. And there's more of the volunteers. The gentleman there is Pastor Ishan Arjun. He mobilized most of the volunteers mm-hmm. to come to that project and did a fantastic job in the whole western side of Port of Spain. That those areas we go to, they were untouched.
Wow.
Yes.
Wow.
Yeah.
So a lot of people then had access to spiritual literature.
Yes.
That's beautiful.
And especially from 3ABN and our flyers there. We also had a contact list mm-hmm. if you want to find out more, if you want a Bible study as well. And there's someone who is working on a practical level to get to give those people their Bible studies as well.
Nice.
Right? And so from time to time, I'll follow up with her, mm-hmm. and she will let us know how is the feedback. Because she's already in the area. Yes.
Yeah, so you had just boots on the ground at all times.
Yes, she is.
That's beautiful. So 50,000 books. What happened at Tobago ASI?
Right, so the plan was to have the 50,000 books, Bridget Berlanti's books, in Trinidad, and 20,000 would be shipped to Tobago.
Okay.
Right, so mm-hmm. When it came, we sent that to Tobago, and the legend that we have in Tobago, Brother Diamond Andrews, he is a legend.
Uh-huh.
He make things happen.
Okay.
Doesn't talk much.
Uh-huh.
Get things done.
Okay.
Very, very quickly. He would mobilize things, anything happen and such, and you want to have a project done, they make it happen. Mm-hmm. They really make it happen across mm-hmm. there. And he's a mover and a shaker.
Okay.
Definitely is. And the 30,000 is what we use in the island. We use about 10,000 for the mailbox project, and the rest we give out to other churches in the community, and they went out. But we had so much need for it, even after the fact that it finished, we got a lot of requests for it, for more, and people wanted a lot more of it in different areas they didn't get, so we tried to distribute it evenly. So some of the areas that got, we had was to ask them, say, can mm-hmm. we use some of your stock for another area? And it was such a joy to know how people want to share.
Yeah.
It's a complete Bible-based book, and it's well put together, and it's really amazing to read.
Mm-hmm. Yes. You know, one of the things that I love about the book Spiritual Vigilantes is that in a world full of compromise, this book points you back to Bible truth.
Correct.
So it makes you want to stand firm on the Word of God, which is what we should be doing anyway, standing
absolutely.
Firm on the principles found in the Word of God.
Yes, absolutely.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So you're spreading that around the island. People are finding out about Christ. They're learning about 3ABN. What other projects have you
done? We've in our trips around the island, mm-hmm. we've met a few people. One of them we've met, her name is Michelle. She has read the same, book 10 Commandments twice removed,
mm-hmm.
and it has shown her from her previous faith how God's truth still mm-hmm. stand. And she has have a testimony here, and
just read that. Yeah,
I'll read part of what she has said.
Mm-hmm.
It says, addressed to Danny Shelton, thank you for writing the book 10 Commandments twice removed. I was not always a Seventh-day Adventist, sorry. And she went to school for 25 years. Now, at 25 years, when I graduated at the Jesuit University in New York, that's where she went.
Okay.
And in her spiritual journey from her former faith, she said, I knew I was not being fed spiritually. So I asked Jesus if he was really God and to show me his love.
Mm.
And her friend, she said, it surprised her when she said she was no longer a member of the Sunday keeping, and she has now became a member of the Seventh-day Adventist Church.
Wow.
So, and her friend loaned her the book 10 Commandments, twice removed, mm-hmm. by Danny Shelton and Shelley Quinn. And the book has shown her logically, as she said here, the book, the 10 Commandments, twice removed, is simple and logical, written with many Bible references that make it quite clear that all the 10 Commandments are to be kept today.
Mm-hmm.
I read for the first time the difference between the burdensome ceremonial law and the holy moral law. The moral law, written by the finger of God on stone, is placed in the sanctuary in the most holy place at the base, the foundation of the mercy seat where God dwells. From Genesis to Revelation, God speaks of his hallowing the Sabbath. And she said when she returned to Trinidad in December 2016, she started to go at the Woodbrook Seventh-day Adventist Church. Mm-hmm. And her first name is Michelle.
Wow. Wow. So, you know, I think that really speaks to the importance of literature and even the being a call porter or literature evangelist as well, you know, because people read the written word and all of that, and God utilizes that to transform their lives.
Yes, absolutely, absolutely. We have a few more other people as well. Uh-huh. Elizabeth, she made a commitment to the Lord that when she reached a certain amount of zeal in her career, uh-huh, she would want to be baptized. But when her mom, who was searching for God as well, got introduced to 3ABN, not for weeks or months, but within the day, within the hour, she said, when she looked at the presentation, she said, that was the truth. She knew that was the truth, and mm-hmm, it is completely Bible-based. So her mother influenced her and showed her where that what is being aired on 3ABN is completely and totally Bible-based.
Yes.
And yes. So before she reached her goal in sales, she asked me to arrange a baptism, and she got baptized.
Nice.
We give her a certificate of baptism, and she got baptized just probably it's about 3 months after watching 3ABN.
Wow.
And her journey...
Praise the Lord.
Her journey is a journey of where she searched from different faith to another faith, to from doing this and to doing all sorts of things. Mm-hmm. And you can, when you sit with someone and you hear their experience, where they have been searching and they've been searching and they're still not finding. And when they see the programs and hear the programs that we introduce them to, and they actually spend time in researching what messages, and they check the Bibles and see, it is what is in the Bible. They were so amazed. They said, this is true. And the Holy Spirit works through them.
Yes.
Works through them and works with them, and they accept Christ. Mm-hmm. And that is be such a joy. We've had, we have a gentleman this year as well. Mm-hmm. He is a pioneer in his faith. Mm-hmm. And what he, we were at a meeting in his area, and one of the persons there mentioned to me that this gentleman, they know he's watching 3ABN for probably about 2 years now, and he has stopped going to his faith because he wasn't being fed. And the Lord had showed him that what is being showed and what has been aired on 3ABN, it's completely Bible-based, and he did his homework and rest, and he stopped attending that mm-hmm faith. So he stays home and watch 3ABN. But he has a challenge at his home because his wife is of another faith. So okay, he asks us to pray for him. Mm-hmm. But I told him it's about God's love.
Yes.
Right? And it's what we present there in 3ABN is about God's love for man. Mm-hmm. And once you fall in love with God and you realize and you spend time in His Word, He will guide you by step in journey. Mm-hmm. Because we have all reached different journeys and in our lives. Mm-hmm. But some of us, when we reach a journey, we expect people to be at that journey when we want them, when we meet them.
Yeah, we're all at different places in our walk.
Yes.
Yes.
So
yes,
it's a challenge when you meet people, and some people want to do the Holy Spirit work. Mm-hmm. I tell people we are called to catch the fish, not to scale it. So I hope they catch that perception clear as uh-huh well. Yes. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. So we have Jennifer. We have Jennifer watching 3ABN for at least 2 years. Uh-huh. I met her about 2 months ago. This
oh,
is
wow
her. She a former faith, and she approached me and said, I'm watching 3ABN for the past 2 years, and I've recently got baptized. Mm-hmm. And it's just, it's a joy just to hear her testimony. And she wants to do more for the Lord. She is retired, but she wants to do a lot more. Mm-hmm. And so we connect her with ASI Trinidad, uh-huh, and she is supporting them, whatever she can as well. And of course, 3ABN.
Yes, yes.
As well.
And that's what it's all about, is, you know, these programs exist to point people to Christ.
Yes.
And also give them practical tools for Christ, you know, to live a Christian life.
Yes, absolutely.
So I love these testimonies.
Then we have Anthony, just this year. God just made him move mighty in his life. Where he had was to, he got, he had noticed to leave where he was renting, and God provide him with the funds to fit the next rent for the new place. Mm-hmm. And he just keep giving me these testimonies, and it was just so amazing.
Yeah.
And it just happened, and he just watching amazing facts on 3ABN as well. And God just revealed to him that what we share, again, our quality programs, are completely Bible-based.
Mm-hmm. So talk to me about, you also did some things with food.
Yes, yes.
Was it like a food pantry? What happened there? Tell me a little bit about that.
Yes, if I may, before we go there, what we have been doing, when we are invited to projects or events in my island, we send prayer requests to the pastoral team, JD and his team.
Yes.
And one of the most recent praise reports was that there was an event last year in October, and the year before, it rained for the entire event, which was on Sabbath.
Mm-hmm.
So I sent a prayer request to JD and his team, asking them to please pray that it does not rain on that day for the event.
Uh-huh.
It rained most of the week up until Friday night. And for the Sabbath, it did not rain at all. And everywhere around the area got affected by rain, and it rained as well, but not that location. Mm-hmm. I was really amazing to know that, and be grateful for JD and his pastoral team for their prayers and the continuous support. Because again, it's God who makes these things happen for our events and events that we invited to as well.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So, coming to the food hamper distribution, we from time to time we get sponsorship from the Supermarket Association and others, and we connect with the community services arm of the Adventist Church to reach out to people. And there are other members as well who need food supplies. Some of them are unemployed. Some of them, they can't make ends meet. Some of them are single parents. Sometimes their house burned down, and a lot. So we for the year so far, we have distributed over 3,000 grocery and bakery items thus far for the year. And that is only based on sponsorship. This is one of the trip. On a Sabbath afternoon, we went out, and this is one of the volunteers, and we did about probably about 10 homes that Sabbath afternoon. And this is another home that we did. This is a club in the St. James Police Youth Club. It's a bunch of young people coming together to come out of high-risk areas. So the St. James Police Youth Club introduced them to sports, games, and a lot of activities just to direct their energy to the right path. So we lend them the support of these grocery items that they need, because they are an NGO as well.
Nice.
And those are some of the pictures that we have distributed. Some of these pictures we don't show for some people, because we respect their privacy as well. And some of them, they don't wish to take pictures, and that's fine. But it's a great joy when we meet them. We give them any of our flyer, Trabian flyer, and we give them whatever books that we have to let them know about God's amazing love.
Amen. You've also been to the U.S. Embassy out there. Talk to us a little bit about that, too.
Yes. The U.S. Embassy, we have networked with them earlier this year in April, where the Caribbean Union office, Dr. Pastor Clive Dutton, have reached out to Trinidad and would love to have us on board a sports caravan. And on that sports caravan, where it is, we go into a very high-risk area and introduce more sports to them, to the children and the youths. And it was, we had a match which was supposed to take at least an hour for the most. We matched for over 3 hours. And it was it was really fun. Mm-hmm. It was really fun. Mm-hmm. We got the...
Over 3 hours.
Yes, over 3 hours as well. It was really a great event. We have also met with Dean from Dean Wheels.
Okay.
He has a monster truck.
Okay.
So he was also, he came on board the Adventist Church via TDY190052 as well.
Wow. And so he came into the Adventist Church through watching 3ABN.
Yes, he did.
Praise the Lord.
So the event was on a Sunday, and on Sabbath, we were looking for somebody to transport about 50 cases of water, and we did not have anyone. So I was nearby at the Adventist Church there, and I saw a vehicle, and I asked, whose one is that? And then I started to talk with him, and he gave me his story. And I asked him if he would like to come to the event tomorrow, and he did. So he brought his monster Ford Ranger F-250.
Uh-huh. And I think we actually have a picture.
Yes.
Of that.
Yes. So that is Dean in the blue.
Okay.
This is his Ford Ranger F-250. Children loved it. Mm. They all wanted to go on it, ride on it, just to take pictures. And it was a great fun for the children to be there as well. And we thank Dean for what he has done.
Yes.
In adding joy to the children as well.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
So, wow. So you've done the sports caravan thing, the U.S. Embassy. Talk to me about the evangelistic meeting.
Yes, the evangelistic meeting we hold, we supported Pastor Ishan Arjun for evangelistic meeting in Maraval, Paraman. And in that meeting, we were present there to give out flyers in the community. And he did a fantastic 2 weeks presentation to that community as well. And people get to know more about TDY190052 as well. Because we went in the community, had the youths put on a beautiful question. And when you answer the question correctly about crime, they give you a gift, like a little gift as well. So it was really fantastic on a Sabbath.
So it was almost like a trivia type?
Yes, it was really, really fun. And I was really happy to see the children did that as well.
And so what else, what other events or projects have you been a part of?
Yes, for the past 3 years, over 3 years, we have partnered with Panangelic Steel Pan.
Okay.
That is, again, hosted, well, directed by Pastor Ishan Arjun. Mm-hmm. And this picture is part of the Paraman, Maraval Paraman group.
Nice.
We went out in the community as well. And we'll see how what we have done every for the past 3 years is go to the malls in our island and share the love of God during the Christmas holidays. So we put together the youths, children and the youths, and we go into the malls all over the island. Wherever we get permission, we go there, and we've also distributed flyers. We have youths and children to all corners of the mall, people who are entering, go into the stores, on people inside the mall, and we give them the Spiritual Vigilantes book, the Ten Commandments, the flyers, and whatever materials we have to share. TDY190052 as well.
Yes.
And we have our 14-foot TDY190052 Bobana as well displayed.
Nice.
As well. Yeah. For the past 3 years, we've been doing that as well. Yes.
Praise the Lord. So you've been very, very active out there in Trinidad and Tobago. And it sounds like You know, the island is well aware of 3ABN.
They are, and they get into more of it. The challenge is that we are an NGO, so funding to advertise in the media, as in press and radio, is costly.
Yes.
Right. But when we are in the community, people get to know that we're there and come and ask us questions, and we let them know what we are about.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
Another project that we did for over a year at different periods is the Princess Elizabeth Hospital for handicapped children. God put it in such a way that He brought someone, connect someone to me, who was a director of that hospital. And they have had a lot of frequent flooding, and the wheelchairs there, some of them were broken and got damaged and such. Mm-hmm. So they were trying to have it removed. And in the pictures, you will see shortly, that's a 20-foot bin. We filled that up with, is over two of that we full, plus almost three, almost three, with broken wheelchairs, beds, a whole lot of debris. So the idea was to use one room, and we end up cleaning up the entire compound that had broken stuff. Mm-hmm. We also got paint sponsored, and we did a complete paint on the compound with the volunteers of the members of the Woodbrook Seventh-day Adventist Church, who came on board, and they were so happy to know this is where they were painting the wall of the compound on the back. It's practically a whole facelift we did on that compound. And it was really amazing job to know that we shared some joy with the children, because the place was not looking up to par.
Yes.
Up to par.
Yes.
And it was really fun to actually have the volunteers come. And we had some children involved as well, because wherever we go, we try to have the children from in the community or the parents to be present, because once they see that the parents are involved in this community work, they get to, it spreads with them, it grows with them as well. Right?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
That is absolutely incredible. And, you know, I can't believe that we're running low on time. We still have some more to share, but prior to talking about maybe some of the needs of 3ABN Trinidad and Tobago, we're gonna go to another song. And this is going to be sung by Pam Lister, and it's entitled His Life for Mine.
His heart was broken, mine was mended. He became sin, now I am clean. The cross He carried bore my burden. The nails that held Him set me free. His life for mine, His life for mine. How could it ever be that He would die, God's Son would die to save suffering brought me healing. He spilled His blood to fill my soul. His crown of thorns made me royalty. His
Wow, His Life for Mine. What a beautiful, beautiful song. Rodney, we've talked about all of these projects that 3ABN Trinidad and Tobago has been a part of, but we didn't cover the health fairs.
Yeah, the health fairs, we get invited by the Member of Parliament and our landing government to come on board the health fair. Mm-hmm. This one is from the Life Hope Center, where the legend of our land, Dr. Pastor Clive Dutton, invited us recently to open that other aspect of the center. Mm-hmm. And on the other pictures, right, we were at Nestle Health Fair. And this is our Dr. Dosh, who volunteered his time, and the line was growing really long to actually do first full contact with people and speaking to them one-on-one.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Wow. So I saw that there was quite a bit of traffic at that event.
Yeah, we had a traffic between 3,000 to 5,000 people that day. In one day.
Wow.
Well, it's actually just for a few hours. And it's really amazing to know how people came and they get to know about 3ABN.
Yes.
Yeah, and that particular day, yeah.
What are some of the needs at 3ABN Trinidad and Tobago?
We have a great amount of work to get done more in Trinidad. Mm-hmm. We need to bring in more of our books, mm-hmm, and our materials to share God's love for people. Mm-hmm. And a lot more we want to do in Trinidad. So, to the people who are listening and the viewers, we ask you if you could kindly grant us your support and let us know that we can reach more people, population of 1.5 million, and we can do a whole lot more. We have volunteers who will come on board from projects to projects, and the need is great.
Yes.
And what we discuss here in projects is just a portion of what we do in Trinidad.
Wow. That's just a portion.
Yes.
Wow, so there's so much more that's going on. So you need volunteers, you need people to spread the word, you need,
yes,
prayers, you need, yeah, financial support as well.
Yes, yeah, yes, yes.
Yes.
We need a lot of support in Trinidad and Tobago.
Mm-hmm, yes. Mm-hmm. Well, the beautiful thing is it seems like people have been catching the vision.
Yes.
They've grabbed hold of 3ABN, Trinidad and Tobago,
yeah,
and they're spreading the word and passing out the literature, and we hope that more people will get involved.
Yes, we pray and hope so that we have more volunteers come on board and that they come and help us to reach more people.
Absolutely. Well, right now, we are going to go to your contact information and then to a news break, and we'll be right back.
3ABN TV Trinidad and Tobago is preaching the gospel through television and distributing evangelistic literature. If the Lord impresses you to support this outreach, here's the contact information. 3ABN TV Trinidad and Tobago, Post Office Box 220, West Frankfort, Illinois 62896. You can call them at 868-341-4111. That's 868-341-4111. You can email them at 3abntt@3abn.tv or find them on the web at tt3abn.tv.
Wow, this time went by fast. You know, if you saw the address roll and you were thinking, well, I want to send in some support for 3ABN Trinidad and Tobago. Your funds will come to 3ABN headquarters here in the States, but make sure that you mark 3ABN Trinidad and Tobago on the memo line so we know how to allocate those funds. Rodney, is there anything on your heart that you would like to share with the viewers at home?
There are many things I want to share. One of the things that we do in Trinidad and Tobago is that we add 3ABN to all the key providers, and there's more to add as well. We would love to have more volunteers on board to give us support in projects and to catch the vision of what 3ABN is completely surrounded in our island. Mm-hmm. And one of the slogans that we use in Trinidad is that 3ABN is mission focused,
mm-hmm,
mission driven, more mission, less talk.
Mm.
Because people tend to have frustrated about how projects are being done and it's not reaching the people as well. But once you get involved with 3EBN's work, it will show you how God's hand's in it.
Amen.
And he makes it happen.
Mm-hmm.
Never me, but him.
Yes, yeah. Yes. And how lives are transformed.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Yes.
Yeah.
You know, I hope that one day I'll get to visit Trinidad and Tobago and come see you in action and all of those wonderful volunteers and the lives that have been transformed. Thank you so much for sharing with us.
Yeah.
And thank you for watching or listening. Until next time, God bless.